In this problem, we're releasing a rock from rest at a height of 5.44 meters above the ground, and we're trying to solve for the time it takes to hit the ground and then the speed of the rock when it hits the ground. So before we start, I want to make it clear that we're going to use the approximation of g as 9.8 meters per second squared. In other words, the rock is going to accelerate downward at 9.8 meters per second squared. The other thing we should clarify is our coordinate system, and the most popular way to set that up is to put the origin at the lowest point of the problem, in other words, the ground. So there's our little coordinate axes as a reminder, and we put zero at the ground and we're calling upward the positive direction. Now it's also possible to analyze this problem using downward as the positive direction, but the important thing is that we stick to our coordinate system once we've chosen it. So in part A, we want to find the time for the rock to land, and we know the final position when the rock lands. That's y equals zero when the rock hits the ground level. So we should be able to get a handle on the time for this process by looking at our first constant acceleration kinematics equation. And we're going to use a y for this since it's a vertical problem. So we have y equals y naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. And so our final y value when this thing hits the ground, that's zero. The initial velocity, well, it was released from rest, so that's zero as well. And since we know the initial y value of 5.44 meters, and we know the acceleration caused by gravity, t is the only unknown in this equation, and we should be able to solve for that pretty quickly. So we plug in zero for our final y value, put in 5.44 for our initial y value, and then for A, we have to be faithful to our coordinate system here. A points downward and has a magnitude of 9.8. So that's going to be negative 9.8 meters per second squared. And then we have our unknown t squared. Now half of 9.8 is 4.9. So we have a negative 4.9 t squared. We can go ahead and add that to both sides and write 4.9 t squared is equal to 5.44. Dividing by 4.9 on both sides, we can say that t squared is about 1.11. The units on that would be seconds squared. And finally, taking the square root and keeping just the positive answer here, t is going to be 1.05 seconds if we round to our traditional three significant digits. In part B, we want the speed when the rock hits the ground. And for this, we can just use our kinematic equation for the velocity as a function of time. So that's v equals v naught plus at. And the final velocity there is what we're trying to solve for. Note that in the question we were asked for the speed, so at the end we'll have to find the magnitude of that velocity. So we want to solve for that final velocity v. We know our initial velocity was zero. We know the acceleration induced by gravity, and we know how long this rock takes to hit the ground. So we just plug in the acceleration induced by gravity, that's negative 9.8, the time the rock took to hit the ground, that's 1.05 seconds. Into three significant digits, we get a final velocity of negative 10.3 meters per second. And again, we were asked for the speed at which it hits the ground, and that's just the size of the velocity vector. So it has a minus sign because it pointed downward, but the size of the velocity vector, that's the speed we're looking for, and that's just 10.3 meters per second. Now before we quit, I want to bring up one way that we could check our work in this problem. And that's by using our third standard formula for constant acceleration kinematics. This is the one that's time independent. And that's v squared equals v naught squared plus 2a times the displacement, so y minus y naught. And we know our initial velocity was zero, so that term is gone. We know our final position is zero, so that term is gone. So we get v squared is equal to twice the acceleration, which is negative 9.8, times the negative of y naught, the negative of the initial height, so 5.44 meters. And when we smash all those numbers on the right, we get 106.6. Taking the square root of both sides, we can find v. And note that we get positive and negative solutions here, and we're keeping the positive one again because we're looking for the speed, the magnitude of the velocity vector. And when we run the numbers on this, we come out with 10.3 meters per second again. So it agrees with our first answer, and we're confident we got it right. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zacks Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.